everyone, I'm Amanda Brewer, plant product marketer, and today I'm here with Abbas Ali, plant product manager, to talk about what's new in the latest release of OpenPlant. So Abbas, tell us, what's new in OpenPlant Connect Edition Update 4?
Thanks, Amanda. Hello, everyone. OpenPlant Connect Edition Update 4 is now released and available on software downloads. We are very excited with how these update releases are coming along. This is giving us a chance to not only improve the existing workflows in our products, but also we are able to implement some new features on quarterly basis. OpenPlant Connect Edition Update 4 has few new bells and whistles along with journal stability improvements. So let's first talk about OpenPlant Modeler. As we had mentioned earlier, the external reports have undergone a bit of a remakeup. We cleaned up the default list of reports that are shipped and added few new reports, for instance, pipelines and bill of material. All these reports can serve as templates for our users to see how they are generated, and they can customize these for their own requirements. Bill of material report is a good example, as now it shows how to put conditional values in various columns, as well as how text values and multiple columns are concatenated for desired results. You can always open these reports in Report Designer to have a look at behind the scenes of how these reports are created. Report Designer can be launched from OpenPlant Project Administrator. Once a report is opened in Edit View, you can easily see how the layout and values for specific columns have been set. For advanced example, specific logic can be written in script section, and in default reports, some samples are available. For example, how we are calculating the accumulated lengths of pipes, etc. We do plan to continue enhancing the content, look and feel, and list of reports in future Connect Edition updates. In OpenPlant Modeler, there are various updates now available for iModel Hub integration. I will not be able to cover all of them, but we can talk about Consistency Manager. Consistency Manager dialog is updated to provide new features and ease of use. Collapse and expand options are now available to either show only instance tree or show all the dialogs. This will help in placement workflows, which are available in Update 4. Context menu on instances provide options for placement classes. There are some mapping options added to configure what classes to show for each PNID instance. There are new 3D placement icons to show if the item is placed, is synced to iModel, or is just present in the active file. There is a legend available in Settings tab for all the symbols and icons used in Consistency Manager. This will come in very handy in getting up to speed on reading the data in Consistency Manager. On the main ribbon, view options, zoom, highlight, and isolate are added to quickly see the component in the right context. One main implementation in Update 4 is the ability to update and sync the differences in 3D model. There are multiple ways you can do this. You can individually select the checkboxes on properties that are different. You can choose to select all the properties in one go, or there is an option to stage the instance in context menu for update. And in main ribbon, you can also choose to select all the differences in one go. There is a reset button to undo your selection, and hitting save would update your active model. The color also changes for the selected instances to help user visually distinguish the items he wants to update. There are some properties that are marked as not editable from Consistency Manager. And the intention is for such properties that the change should be made in authoring application if needed. Of course, this is configurable, and even the properties can be taken out of consistency check altogether. Some similar changes are also done in tag validation dialog to prevent certain classes to be automatically updated for better data checking. Of course, here again, this is a configurable option. We wanted to give users some control how these validation options are configured. We are working on fine-tuning some of these workflows and may update these further in upcoming updates.
So how about the other design applications like OpenPlant Support Engineering and OpenPlant PID? Are there updates to those?
Primary focus for these both of these applications were stabilization or continuing to improve on the existing workflows. One new change in OpenPlant PID I would like to mention here is the new active association dialog. Basically, we are working to make the definition of plant breakdown objects simpler and consistent across design applications. This is the first step in OpenPlant PID to show all the available associations in this dialog that you may have in the project, but once they are selected or created in this dialog, they are automatically present in the active drawing to be consumed by placement and other subsequent operations. Now, you do not need to add and create these separately in the plan tab of PNID document dialog. There are further settings available to use alias instead of actual name if some other description has to be presented in the interface. You can even choose to not show certain associated objects that may be present in the project but are not relevant to current drawing. This dialog can be docked and will ease in selecting and defining these objects. For OpenPlant Support Engineering, we are working to make sure that all the support engineering functionality is available within OpenPlant Modeler. Now, this feature is not released with Update 4, but our team is aiming to get this rolling and be ready for the release in the next update.
And how about the deliverable products? Are there any updates to OpenPlant Isometrics Manager or OpenPlant Orthographics Manager?
You know, we take our deliverables products very seriously. Well, actually, we do that for all the products. But yes, there are updates for both OpenPlant Isometric Manager and OpenPlant Orthographics Manager. One key thing is that these products are now integrated with iModel Hub. So in OpenPlant Isometrics, you can connect to an iModel defined in a Connect project, reference out a model, and then generate isometric drawings directly from this data by selecting ISO sheets. With Update 4, you can have better control of your isometric content with this new ability to generate what we are calling system ISO. But basically, it lets you group by any specific data criteria and gives ability to publish a isometric view. There is also an option added for better weld numbering control in the OpenPlant Isometric Manager. You can now choose if you want to restart weld numbering for each sheet or want it sequentially across different sheets for your isometric drawings. Besides this, there are various defects and enhancements fixed in our deliverable products. I would strongly encourage you to participate in our tech talks and webinars, specifically for isometric workflows. For Orthographics Manager, we have added a button to connect to iModel Hub in View Definition dialog. And once connected, you can reference out the required model from iModel Hub tab. This model can be used to create your view definitions, and then orthographics drawing will be published. So there's no need to add specific files when you are publishing drawing directly from iModel Hub in this workflow.
Finally, we are getting some really good feature requests and feedback from our recent tech tips on OpenPlant Project Administrator. Can you tell us if there are any updates to admin workflows or to the iModel Data Manager?
Yeah, sure. So tech tips are really good way to learn new tips and tricks about our products or to even know about new features and usability of those features in a quick manner. So let me just highlight a few updates about OpenPlant Project Administrator. There is a new option now to add units for properties in Schema Editor. You can associate correct units or have option to mark certain properties as unitless. Also, you can load any schema now in schema editor. Previously, only modeling schemas were listed in the drop-down. In schema upgrade tool, we added option to export the list of changes or differences in a schema to a CVS file. This way, users can compare their changes against a default out-of-the-box schema and can view these even in an Excel file. This should help in upgrade configuration setup process. Coming to iModel Data Manager, this portal also is being updated constantly, and we are working to improve the user interface as well as add new capability. Tag creation is not done for update 4, but now you can create queries, save queries as my queries that are visible to only you, or promote them as shared queries to be visible to all the participants of connected project. There are now options available to add or hide columns in the grid view as well as change their position. So we are continuing to work on editing and creation capabilities in iModel Data Manager, and hopefully we'll be releasing these soon.
Well, that's all we have for OpenPlant Connect Edition 4. Thank you guys so much for joining us, and thank you, Boss, for the great information. Be sure to check out our latest tech tips and latest tech talks so that you can stay in the know with what's new in OpenPlant. We'll see you soon.
Thanks, everyone.